Hello, my name is Judith Teitelman, and I'm so pleased to have the opportunity to introduce you to my debut novel, Guesthouse for Ganesha, a tale of love, loss, and spirit reclaimed. Two key and seemingly disparate elements inspired my novel's development. Firstly, just after her funeral, I learned that my grandmother, always mean-spirited and difficult, at only 17, had been left to stand under the chuppah, alone, her beloved having run off with the wealthiest girl in their shtetl. It was the first time I had a real understanding of this woman. I had always attributed her challenging personality to experiences suffered during the war, losing family, husband, and children. But no, it was devastated love at an early age that had formed her personality and temperament. This was the spark that compelled me to honor her ordeal, which is an all too common, even a universal experience. But I knew it must be couched in the largest context possible, with not just an omniscient narrator, but a Hindu god, who would concurrently honor my lifelong interest in Eastern cultures and philosophies. My novel's narrator, as well as character, is the beloved elephant-headed Ganesha, one of the best-known and most worshipped deities in the Hindu pantheon. He journeys with my protagonist Esther, a young Jewish woman, pre-World War II, during the war when she passes as a Gentile master tailor furrier, working with the resistance to survive, and after when she goes to India. In its essence, it's a story about what it means to be human, and ultimately, it's a story about love. Left at the altar, spurned. What does that do to a young woman's heart, and why would a Hindu god care?